Hi everyone, I'm Parikshit and today we have with us Ms. Piyush Mahajan, who's a certified life coach and a soft skills facilitator. She has over 11 years of experience in the geospatial industry, where she worked as a senior data specialist. Having found her life's calling, she gave up her promising career and decided to become a life skills coach. Today, she will share with us her journey so far and her motivations for choosing a career that allows her to make a difference to other people's lives. Piyush, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Tell us about yourself and why you chose to become a life skills coach.
I actually did my certified life coach certification 2 years back, and I have about 11 years of corporate experience. I love interacting with people, and that was the reason I was very much involved in the activities which used to happen in an organization, wherein people were involved. I used to have team building activities, employee engagement things within my team as well, and I used to just volunteer about that. So it was not a part of my work, but I used to love doing it. And as a Toastmasters, I have been doing public speaking. I love speaking in front of public, and that was the reason I was thinking that there is something that I need to do. I remember when we had to set goals about 3 years back, and we had to develop some of our plans, which were like individual development plans. And I added some leadership trainings in my IDPs. And wherein my manager said that you are into technical, but your goals are more into leadership. So why don't you rethink your decision? So that was the reason, that was the time where I thought that how about doing something of myself? How about doing something which I love doing? Many people have told me that you should follow your passion. And that was the point wherein I was looking for work-life harmony as well. And I had to take care of my kid. I wanted to spend time and, you know, give a value to him as well. So I thought that, okay, let's do it. So at one point I thought, let me do it about 2 years later. But then it was like, take a decision and do it. So I actually left my 11 years of corporate experience last year. Not even a year has passed. But yes, I'm enjoying my journey because it has been both ways. I'm taking care of my profession and my personal life as well.
Tell us about the kind of people you work with.
I usually work with the young adults who are going to be professionals and new professionals. And I work in the aspects of career confusion and career transition. So these set of people have a lot of confusion in them. What they are doing, what they want to do, they do not have clarity. So I work with these set of people.
Can you share an interesting experience you had by helping a client?
I can share an experience which is very relevant to these set of people. I was coaching a client who has already done his BTech in IT. And now he was confused whether he wants to do MBA or job. So he had more inclination towards MBA. But he said that where should I do MBA? What is the what is the specialization shall I take? Then during the tenure of the session, I asked him just one question, that why he wants to do an MBA, and he had no answer. He actually was figuring out and going here and there to understand that why he wants to do MBA. So at times what I have seen is that these young people, they start doing some courses wherein they themselves do not know that why they are doing it. What is the objective that they want to achieve with that? And during the discussion, it was also found that while I was asking him questions, he also found that while I am planning for MBA, my friends will do job. Then there will be a peer pressure as well. So he finally decided that no, I should go for job, and then maybe in future I'll go for MBA, because he just wanted to do it without any reason. And these are such cases that we see, wherein they are confused what to do, from where to do, but why to do, they are not clear.
What approach do you use while working with people who are facing challenges?
As a life coach, we have a very different approach for coaching. So the coaching approach is asking questions, asking right set of questions to help client find their own solutions. So as a coach, we believe that a client, whosoever has come to us to have a solution, to find a solution for their own challenges, we believe that they are capable of finding their own solutions. It is just that they need little push, little confidence, and maybe they just want to fall in a system, or they have multiple options and they are not able to figure out what they want to do. So therein we work as an accountability partner with clients, and we help them find their own solutions. So it is they who find the solutions, it is they who take actions, and we help them find those by asking the right set of questions.
Jagran Josh's audience is mostly young students or young professionals. What is that key skill that you think they need to develop, and how can they develop that?
If I talk of key skill, there are many skills, but I think I'll be able to make it concise with the journey of a child to a grown-up. So we as parents try making our kids responsible and, you know, capable of taking their own actions. So from a kid, we start telling him, we start teaching him that this is the work that you have to do. And then when he grows up, we help him to take his own decisions, to, you know, choose the career of his choice. Then when he's in higher studies, we help him understand that he has to be his own owner. So that's what I think is the key skill. We have to take ownership, we have to be responsible for whatever actions we take, and start behaving as leaders. So when we think that we are the leaders, then when we start behaving like that, I think that will be shown when we actually go into a corporate life. And that's where a leader should have a capability to be a great team player. He should be responsible for his own actions, he should be empathetic, and should be responsible for uncertainties that are coming in today's dynamic world.
Do you have a life mantra, and would you like to share it with our audience?
I think I follow many life mantras, but the latest one that I have been following is I read a quote which says that I want to see what happens if I do not give up. I relate myself very closely to it. So in case I'm very clear on what is my goal, if I know where I want to reach, and even if it is a tortoise walk, I know that this is the place I need to reach, I would never give up and see that what will happen, and the results will always be positive. And I think this applies to each individual in this world, wherein if we focus on our objectives and pave our way to reach those objectives, we will obviously succeed. And so the key is you should not give up.
Thanks for taking the time to speak to our audience. I'm sure our viewers will benefit from your inspirational life story and experiences.
It was great being here, and I'm happy to address the audience of Jagran Josh.
So this was Ms. Piyush Mahajan, who found her life's calling as a life coach and soft skills facilitator. What's your life's calling? Stay tuned to jagranjosh.com. You just might find the answer.